The end goal of data viewer usage for most research studies involves the output of the actual data files. Data viewer has several output report options, each containing dozens of possible variables that can be included. In this video, we'll cover the basics of reports and the organizing principles underlying them. In another video, we'll focus on the Bend Time Course Analysis report. Once you've set up the interest periods for your viewing session, and once you've set up any interest areas that you might need for your analysis, you're ready to create reports. Reports are output text files that will contain the relevant data for your analysis, and they can be created by going to the Analysis Reports menu. Each type of report provides a different way of organizing the data from your viewing session, and the name of each report indicates what the contents of each row of the output file will be. If you create a fixation report, each row in the output file will correspond to a different fixation from the viewing session. If you create a saccade report, each row will correspond to a different saccade. If you create an interest area report, each row will correspond to a different interest area, and so on. When you choose to create a report, a dialog will appear that will allow you to choose which variables will go into the report. These variables will become columns in the output file, and you can click on each variable to see its definition below. To add a variable so that it becomes a column in the output file, simply select it and use the arrow button to move it over to the Selected Variables section. Recording Session Label, which is the EDF file name, and Trial Index, which is the trial number for a given participant, will be included by default. For a fixation report, we might want to include Current Fix Index, which will be the ordinal number of the fixation within the trial. In other words, 1, 2, 3 for first, second, and third fixations of the trial. We might also want to include Current Fix Duration, which is the duration of the fixation, and Current Fix X and Current Fix Y, which are the X and Y coordinates of the fixation, respectively. We could also include the size of the pupil and information about which interest area the fixation was in. Note, these interest area variables will have missing values if the fixation was not in any interest area. Importantly, all the trial variables from the viewing session will be included as possible variables for the output file, and they'll be listed at the bottom of the Available Variables section and colored blue. We probably would want to include all of the trial variables, as those typically contain our condition or independent variable information, as well as the values of any behavioral data that we might have collected for each trial, like accuracy or reaction time information. If you want to change the left-right ordering of the variables in the output file, then you can use the up and down arrows to reorder them in the Selected Variables section. By default, reports will contain all of the data for all participants, and will include only the data from the currently selected interest period. You can change the settings at the bottom of the report creation dialog if you'd like to create a separate report for each participant, or if you'd like to include all interest periods in the output data, either by including all interest periods as separate sections of the same report, or by creating a separate report for each interest period in the viewing session. After we create the report, we can open it in any statistics package to check the data and perform any inferential statistics on the data. I'll open it in Excel here, just so we can take a quick look. Once it's open, we'll see that each row represents a different fixation, and the columns are the variables that we selected when creating the report. The available variables are different for each of the different types of reports. An interest area report will be organized such that each row is an interest area, so its available variables are ones that will relate to interest areas. We can create an interest area report to illustrate this. For an interest area report, we'd probably want to include information about the interest area ID and label first. Since each row will be a different interest area, This will help us to identify which interest area a given row corresponds to. For an interest area report, the simplest and most commonly used dependent measures are IA dwell time and IA dwell time percentage, which are the sum of the durations of all the fixations on the interest area and the percentage of this dwell time on the interest area, respectively. You can also include information about how many runs or sets of consecutive fixations on an interest area there were for each trial. And you can include the time when each interest area was first fixated. For interest area reports, the variables with FSA in the name can be really useful. FSA stands for Fixation Sequence Analysis, and these variables can provide information about the transition of fixations within or across interest areas. And again, the trial variables can be included in the report too. We can take a look at this report in Excel too. We can see that each row corresponds to a different interest area, and we have all the variables that were chosen when we created the report included as columns. If you want to look at the data at the finest level, then you can create a sample report. This will create an output file where each row corresponds to a different sample. So, for example, if your data were recorded at 1000 Hz, you'll have 1000 rows per second of recorded eye tracking data in the output file. This type of report is particularly useful for studies on smooth pursuit eye movements, where it's critical to have as much information as possible about the eye position over time. The sample report also allows you to include velocity, acceleration, and pupil size information about the eye over time as well. If your experiment sent target position messages to the EDF file to keep a record of the position of a moving target over time, then you can include information about the position, velocity, and acceleration of the target as well. And you can include resolution data, which gives you the number of pixels per degree of visual angle in the horizontal and vertical dimensions. This information will allow you to do things like convert the distance between the target and eye from screen pixel units to degrees of visual angle. Note, the sample report breaks down the data for the two eyes separately. So data from the right eye will be represented by variables with right in the label, and data from the left eye will be represented by variables with left in the label. There are variables that provide average data across the two eyes as well, which can be useful for binocular recordings. For all of the reports, by default, the output file will contain data from all participants and all trials in the viewing session. If you want to exclude some trials from the reports, then you can select a trial or group of trials in the inspector and check the property Exclude from Reports. The settings of the reports can also be configured under the Preferences tab of the inspector in the Output Analysis section. And you can read more about the various report options and access a listing of variable definitions in the Data Viewer User Manual under the section Data Analysis and Output.